More than 2 years after the death of a baby in Cherokee County, his mom has now been charged with homicide. News 4's John Eby is on the story live in the digital studio tonight. And John, you spoke with the woman's father, right?
Right. Her father told me today that he thought it had been ruled an accident. Tonight, the coroner explained more about how the death came to be ruled a homicide after all this time.
A few months ago, the mother of Michael Carter posted these pictures of him on Facebook, along with a caption saying she would love him and miss him always. But that mom, 19-year-old Fantasia Barnett-Butler, was charged last Friday with homicide by child abuse. Little Michael died on April 22, 2010.
Well, it's always tragic. Anytime you deal with the death of a child, it's tragic, and it's tragic when it involves not only the young child, but a young mother.
Butler's father said he was shocked when he found out about the arrest. He said he was initially told the death was an accident and that the investigation was closed several months ago. Coroner Dennis Fowler said the investigation was never closed, but that investigators were initially led to believe the death was accidental.
Well, the initial findings indicated that the baby had actually been in the bed with the mother and had actually suffocated while in the bed, either by rollover or getting caught in the covers.
But Fowler said repeated interviews with Butler and other family members over the course of several months led him to rule the death as asphyxiation by squeezing and a homicide. Neither Fowler nor law enforcement officials have revealed exactly what happened to the child, but in the warrant for Butler's arrest, SLED agents said, quote, the death occurred under circumstances manifesting an extreme indifference to human life.
The Cherokee County Sheriff's Office started the investigation, but SLED agents took the lead and actually brought the charges in this case. Tonight, Butler is being held in the Cherokee County Detention Center without bond. John Eby, WIFF News 4, live in the digital studio.